CSPM, CWPP, CASB, C what now? Cloud security is confusing enough. Where did all these acronyms come from? What do they mean? And more importantly, how can they help you figure out how to secure what you're building in the cloud? These C acronyms typically come from the hard work of analysts at firms like Gartner, Forrester, and 451 Research. Despite adding a bit of confusion, these acronyms are actually a tool for simplicity. Each of these terms tries to encompass a set of solutions that are trying to solve a problem through similar approaches. They are a vendor-neutral way of making sense of the jam-packed cloud security market. As a builder, you can use these acronyms to get a quick idea of what a tool is trying to do without having to parse its marketing message and positioning. Now, the downside is that not every solution fits into a clear box. You're going to see a number of aspects of each of these categories in various products and open source projects, depending on the underlying principles of that tool. And that's okay. The acronyms still serve an important first filter to help you find the right combination of tools for your environment. In this video, we're not going to go deep on the myriad of acronyms for tools meant to protect your organization's users. What we're going to focus on is the acronyms that apply to tools meant to protect what you're building in the cloud. We'll start with the broadest acronym, and that's CSPM. It stands for Cloud Security Posture Management. Now, there's a technical definition somewhere, but what it really boils down to is monitoring the logs and configurations of the services you're using with your cloud service provider, like AWS, Microsoft Azure, or Google Cloud. The goal is to ensure that nothing is misconfigured and things line up with what you're expecting. Misconfigurations are a huge issue in the cloud given the pace of change. And if you're thinking, well, we don't build things that fast, that's fine. Your CSP is still pushing out new services and features all the time that could impact your build. It's part of the advantage of cloud, but it's also really hard to stay on top of. And when you cut through it all, misconfigurations are really just mistakes. Everyone makes mistakes, and tools under the CSPM category can help you spot them before they become a problem. Of course, CSPM tools have more advantages, like helping you meet compliance requirements, implementing best practices, and more. Now, while the PM stands for posture management, I always like to think of tools covering this category as cloud security potential mistake spotters. But I can't add an S to the acronym, so it's a bit clunky. Next on our list is CWPP, or Cloud Workload Protection Platforms. These tools move away from the cloud account, that's CSPM, and focus on the workload. Now, what's a workload, you ask? That's a great question that's actually a bit hard to answer, which, you know, might explain some of the confusion around cloud security tools now that I think about it. For the most part, a workload is a group of servers or containers. Now, it's starting to creep into functions as well, but that's still a bit murky. Essentially, it's compute, which means that these solutions can also reach back into on-premises environments as organizations will be dealing with hybrid deployments for years to come. The idea with CWPP is to provide security controls on the workload to help detect and prevent security problems. Things like threat detection, anti-malware, intrusion prevention, and other security controls pop up as a part of these platforms. Now, you might be wondering why this is a different category when compared to more traditional security ones. Well, it all boils down to that very cloudy C. It means that these platforms need to be able to scale automatically, to tie into the cloud service providers for unique identifiers and organizational structures, and more, all in order to make sure that the tool can handle operating in the cloud. CASB, or CASB, stands for Cloud Access Security Broker. It's on the list here because it comes up a lot due to that pesky C at the start. This category of tools is actually the first that starts to move towards the user side of security. The goal of these tools is to help provide some protection and assurances for organizations using services like Microsoft Office 365, Dropbox, Slack, Box, Google Workspaces, or G Suite, or Google Apps, or whatever they're calling it now. CASB tools aim to give your organization visibility and some measure of control into how you're using these third-party services. Very handy on the user side, and they lead into a new category of tooling called SASE, or Security Access Service Edge. Again, that's on the user side of things, and we're focusing on categories that help protect what you're building in the cloud. So, moving on. CIEM is a relatively new category, and it stands for Cloud Infrastructure Entitlement Management. If you find that confusing, join the club. It sounds like SIEM, or Security Information and Event Management, but it isn't. CIEM is an identity and access management category. Identity changed a lot in the cloud. Sure, you still have users and groups, but now we also have resources and services that require access to data and other resources in a really complex web of interactions. Keeping track of that is hard. Making sure those interactions follow the principle of least privilege is even harder. As a reminder, the principle of least privilege is the tenet of giving a user or resource only the permissions it needs to accomplish a specific task. Now, I would go a step further and add a time dimension there as well. So a user or resource should only have the permissions it needs to accomplish a specific task at a specific time. Now, this is possible today with the tooling made available by the cloud service providers, and this is a highly effective security control. The challenge is in keeping track and managing all of it, thus the new category of CIEM. Finally, we have CNAPP, or Cloud Native Application Protection Platforms. This ambitious acronym adds an extra letter, and why not? It attempts to combine the aspects of cloud security posture management and cloud workload protection platforms into one category. But it also takes things further. Tools in this category also shift left, which really means to push left so that they cover both the development and runtime aspects of security. These solutions are aimed not just at a security audience, but also one practicing a DevOps philosophy. This category is really about an end-to-end approach to cloud security. Now, we know that issues are easier and less expensive to deal with the earlier we catch them in a lifecycle solution. So this means CNAPP is a great fit for this guiding principle. These acronyms are just tools to help you better understand the solution landscape. To that end, it's natural to ask, what category do I need a tool in? However, I don't think that's the most productive approach to the challenge of cloud security. My advice, roll things back to basics. With security tools, you're looking to ensure that your builds work as intended and only as intended. Now, in order to do that, you need to peel things back to two fundamental questions. What's going on in my environment? And are the things I build doing only what I want them to do? To know what's going on in your environment, you'll need solutions that fall under all of these acronyms. Your priorities and your current risk appetite are going to determine where you'll start. Similarly, making sure that what you build is doing only what you want it to do crosses all of these categories as well. So cloud security, it's really conceptually simple, but of course, it's hard to implement. These categories help you understand the approaches taken by different tools, both commercial and open source. Okay, these acronyms are useful. They help you get an idea of what's available to meet your two primary goals: understanding what's going on in your environment and making sure that things are doing only what you want them to do. Let's recap. CSPM is Cloud Security Posture Management, and it looks at data from the cloud service provider and tries to spot misconfigurations, areas for improvement, and it helps with compliance. These tools usually help you meet account level goals. Now, CWPP, that stands for Cloud Workload Protection Platform. These tools operate at the workload or compute level. They're designed to help identify and stop security issues by applying various controls directly where those issues are. Cloud Access Security Brokers, or CASB tools, try to help you rein in software as a service sprawl. These tools give you visibility into your organization's use of Dropbox, Microsoft Office 365, Google Workspaces, and so forth. CIEM is the new acronym on the block, and it stands for Cloud Identity and Entitlement Management. It's all about keeping track of how permissions are used within your environment, whether those permissions are used by people, systems, or services. And finally, for now, we have CNAPP, Cloud Native Application Protection Platforms. Built for more than just the security team, these tools help developers understand the security aspects of what they're building during the development phase. They then use that information to help protect those builds while they're running. So we have five different acronyms with five different purposes. And that's okay. No single tool is going to address all of your security needs, but these acronyms define categories that are useful when you're trying to make sure that you have the right tools in the right place.